Lupin Pharmaceuticals in association with Higher Secondary Principals Forum.
Welcome students to yet another class of English lecture. Today we are going to read and comprehend the sixth chapter of your supplementary reader, On the Face of It. On the Face of It is a play by Susan Hill. Let's realize why the title On the Face of It is apt for the story. The title means that it's not the problem, but the way we look at the problem is a problem. It's the perception that we have which matters. On the face of it is an informal expression used to say that something seems to be good and true, but this opinion may need to be changed once you know the entire truth. Let me give you a brief introduction of our playwright. Susan Hill was born on 5th February 1942 in North Yorkshire. She went to Scarborough Convent School, where she showed interest in theatre and literature. Susan Hill did her English degree at King's College, London. Her novels include The Woman in Black, The Mist in the Mirror, and I'm the King of the Castle, for which she received the Somerset Maugham Award in 1971. Before we get on with the chapter, let me give you a brief of what it's all about. Here is an interesting quote which is quite relevant to the chapter. Don't judge someone based on their appearance. Looks can be deceptive. It can be deceiving. A person who has a disfigured face starts feeling low. They find it difficult to socialize with people. It is when they are undergoing emotional turmoil. You can see in the slide, there are pictures of people you might have seen on the internet who have been through acid attacks. The first picture is of Lakshmi Agrawal, who is on the left-hand side, who faced an acid attack. Below is Resham Khan, who also faced an acid attack in London. Then we have a young child who also faced an attack. What are their feelings? What they must be going through? It is a difficult time for them and they are undergoing an emotional turmoil. Let's see what they are going through. The thoughts that engulf them are, I feel so lonely. I feel someone will hug me. Having everyone stare at my scars, I hide, I wish I was never born. One day I wish I could walk on a street without people shunning away. I sometimes wish it was all just a nightmare. Let me give you a small introduction of the lesson On the Face of It. Here we have a story about a teenage boy, Derry, who has a burnt face, and Mr. Lamb, who is a disabled old man with an artificial leg made of tin. Derry accidentally enters the garden of Mr. Lamb, and Mr. Lamb not only welcomes him in his garden, but also encourages him to lead a normal life, leaving the past behind. Here is Derry, who is a teenager, who is highly pessimistic and withdrawn from the society. He avoided the company of the people because of his disfigured face. The face was disfigured because of the acid. Pessimistic here is gloomy, or someone who is always negative and hopeless. Withdrawn is a person who is introverted or unsociable. They don't like to mingle with people. Mr. Lamb, on the other hand, was an old man with a tin leg. He lived in a big house and he had a lot of books. He overcame his loneliness by reading books and talking to people who came to his garden. Kids teased him by calling him Lamy Lamb. Scene 1 is set in the garden of Mr. Lamb, where one can occasionally hear the birds singing and the low sound of the tree leaves. Crab apples on the tree are, as well as on the ground, are everywhere. Derry, being pessimistic and withdrawn from society, likes these secluded or lonely places. So one day, he scaled the boundary of Mr. Lamb's garden and jumped into it. As soon as he jumped in, he was startled to hear Mr. Lamb's voice, who said, "Mind the apples." "What? Who's that? Who's there?" Derry was startled. He didn't expect anyone in the garden. Mr. Lamb now introduced himself and also said that small sour apples, known as crab apples, had fallen on the ground. If Derry would not be careful while walking through the grass, he could trip over them and get hurt. Derry said that he didn't know that someone was in there, in the garden. He thought it to be empty, even the house to be empty. It seemed empty. Mr. Lamb tells him that the house was indeed empty because Mr. Lamb was out in the garden. Derry decides to leave, which was not liked by Mr. Lamb. Mr. Lamb tried to convince him and he says, "You don't have to leave. I don't mind who comes into the garden. The gate is always open. Only you climbed the garden wall." Derry was angry and upset now. He says, "You were watching me? I had not come here to steal anything." Mr. Lamb agreed by saying that at many times apples had been stolen by young lads and that Derry was not so young. But still, Derry wanted to leave. Mr. Lamb tries to comfort him and says, "Come on, don't be afraid." Derry says, "I'm not afraid of anyone. People are afraid of me." Mr. Lamb questions him, "Why should that be? Why should it be that the people should be afraid of him?" At this, Derry tells him that some people think that he's bad or ugly, while some even take pity on me by saying I'm a poor boy. "But I'm not poor. You are afraid. Anybody would be. I am. When I look in the mirror, I'm afraid of me." Mr. Lamb tells him that he wasn't afraid of Derry. Derry was shocked to hear that. Then Mr. Lamb told him that he would bring a ladder and stick and pick fine and ripe crab apples, as they made a good jelly. He also told him that in September, they get ripe and become a magic fruit, having orange and golden color. He also asked him to join him in doing so. Derry pointed him for changing the topic, just like other people did. He added that Mr. Lamb didn't ask him about his face because he was also afraid like other people. He also mentions that he was annoyed. He doesn't like to be a part of society, to be in the company of people. Mr. Lamb guessed that maybe Derry's face got burnt in some fire when Derry tells him that his face got burnt due to acid. He was so grieved, so sad, that he kept on repeating that acid ate his face and that it would never get cured. Mr. Lamb tells him that he's not trying to change the topic. In fact, he's interested in each and every creation of God. He pointed out at a wall and asked him, "What did Derry see beyond the wall?" Derry looks at things beyond the wall and says, "It is all rubbish, overgrown with weeds." Mr. Lamb tells him, "I make no difference between a flowering plant and a weed. Both are living and growing plants. I find no difference between you, who has a burnt face, with another boy who has a handsome face. Mr. Lamb by now has realized that Derry suffers from a terrible inferiority complex because of his burnt face. Mr. Lamb now tries to explain to him that there are a number of plants in his garden. There were flowers, trees, and herbs. Some plants were considered good and some were called unwanted plants, also known as weed. It was not because they were different. All of them were green in color. It was how about people considered them to be, herbs or weeds. In reality, they were all same, just like Derry and himself. Derry did not agree to this. Mr. Lamb told him that there was no difference. He was young and Mr. Lamb was old. He had a burnt face and Mr. Lamb had a thin leg. These things were not so important and so they didn't make any difference. Derry asked him the reason behind his thin leg. He replied that it got damaged in an explosion many years ago. During a war, Mr. Lamb was in the army. Kids teased him by calling him Lamy Lamb. Derry said that he could cover the thin leg with his trousers so that no one could see it. Mr. Lamb said that it would not bother him much, as one day people will stop teasing him and would start discussing something else. Something like crab apples, weeds, spiders, and the tall sunflowers, which would be a matter to discuss, something they could look at other than Derry or Mr. Lamb. Derry commented that the other things that he mentioned by Mr. Lamb were things, they were non-living things, they were not living. Mr. Lamb replied that all the things were related to each other, just like beauty is related to beast. That is, a beautiful creation is related to ugliness. Derry was now confused, so Mr. Lamb asked for Derry's opinion. When Derry replied that often I have heard people saying that beauty is not related to one's appearance, rather, inner beauty is our real beauty. Even a handsome man is the one who does something good rather than one who looks good. Derry mentions the story of Beauty and the Beast. Once a beautiful girl loved a beast for who he was and kissed him, which turned the beast into a handsome prince. He wouldn't have changed if she hadn't kissed him. But then, I won't change. Derry mentions that nobody is going to kiss him because of his ugly face, to which Mr. Lamb says, yes, you are right. Ugliness is only skin deep. A man is not what he looks like, but what he really is. Well, students, Derry cannot be completely blamed for this pessimistic and aggressive attitude towards people. It was the remarks, it was the comments of the people which had worried him for so long. There were people who would look at him and say, hey, look at him, he looks like a monster. And some would say, only a mother could love a face like this. Your aggressive attitude is violent or unpredictable. He tells Mr. Lamb, I overheard women talking about my ugly face. They said that nobody except my mother could kiss me. He also mentions that his mother chooses the other side of the cheek for kissing him. Mr. Lamb tells him, keep your ears shut and pay no heed to such talks. Pay no heed means pay no attention to such talks. Then he tells him, I have hives of bees. Some say bee buzz and they consider it a jarring noise. But bees hum is like music to me. Still, Jerry is not convinced and he says, I don't like people staring at my face, so I don't go near them and avoid them. Mr. Lamb tries to convince him and tells him that keeping aloof cannot help anybody. It is not going to help anyone by maintaining distance from people. It is not of any use. Then he narrates a short story to Jerry that once there was a man who was always afraid that he might be run over or he might get infection, might meet an accident. He was so afraid that he will be killed someday, so he locked himself in a room. A picture fell off the wall on his head and killed him. So was there any use wondering that things will go wrong? He just locked himself in the room, which was of no use, of course. Very subtly, you can see, students, Mr. Lamb is trying to inject positive thoughts without appearing to be didactic or instructing. And Jerry has slowly started liking Mr. Lamb. Now, you will see a little change in Derry's behavior because now he is interested in knowing what is Mr. Jerry all about, what are his interests. So Jerry asked Mr. Lamb, what did he do all day? To which Mr. Lamb replied that I sit in the sun reading books. He said that the house was full of books. Jerry looked at the house and said that there weren't any curtains on the windows. Mr. Lamb replied that he did not like curtains. He liked transparency, light, darkness, and the wind too. Jerry added that he also liked all of them, and he also liked the sound of the rain falling on the roof of his house. Mr. Lamb commented that Jerry was present-minded as he could hear. Jerry said that his family worried about him, that what would he do in the near future with a burned face. Mr. Lamb said that Jerry has everything, two arms, two legs, two eyes, two ears, etc. He wanted to make Jerry realize that he had so much which many other people were deprived of. He added that Jerry could accomplish a lot if he determined to do so. Jerry asked, how was it possible? And Mr. Lamb replied that the same was as he did. Now, Mr. Lamb tries to get him to help him and says, you can help me in collecting crab apples if you like. To which Jerry says, I want to help you. You could fall off the ladder and die. Jerry said that his mother would be waiting for him. His home was 5 miles away, across the fields. He was 14 years of age, but still he was supposed to tell her where he was. Mr. Lamb added that it is a habit of people to worry. Jerry added that actually they were in the habit of fussing. Mr. Lamb asked Jerry to go home and inform his mother of his whereabouts. His house was 5 miles away. As the weather was fine and he had legs, he could easily go home, tell them and return. Jerry said that once he went home, he would not be allowed to return. To which Mr. Lamb says that once he is home, he might not like to come back himself. Jerry says, you don't know what I can do. To which Mr. Lamb says, only you know what you can do. Then Mr. Lamb tells him that he must go home and come back. Although there are a lot of people who go home saying that they promise to come back, but they never come back. Jerry promises him that he will come back and he leaves. The second scene, students, we are in Jerry's house, where Jerry is talking to his mother and explaining the interesting meet that he had with Mr. Lamb. I want to go back to Mr. Lamb, He is a wonderful person who taught me that looks are not important. His mother, as all mothers are, is very insecure about this new friend he has made. She says that she had already heard about Mr. Lamb. Derry told her not to believe what others said, but she warned him that she knew what was required to know and asked him not to go back. Derry asked her the reason of her fear. He told her that Mr. Lamb was just an old man with a thin leg and had a big house without curtains and a garden. He said that he wanted to go back and listen to things. His mother was curious to know what was it that he was so interested to listen. He replied that he wanted to hear the bees singing and wanted to listen to what Mr. Lamb said. But she didn't find it suitable, and so she told him to stay at home and think about what he wanted to do. Derry said that he hated to remain at home. His mother excused him for speaking wrong because he felt bad and so spoke that way. Derry said that it had nothing to do with his face. The most important thing was how he thought and what he saw or heard. He announced that he would go back into the garden to help Mr. Lamb with the crab apples. His mother tried to stop him, but he ran away, shutting the door behind him. Back in the garden, scene 3, Mr. Lamb was on a ladder, picking apples with the help of the stick, and suddenly the ladder falls. With that, Mr. Lamb falls too. Derry, who had been running back to meet Mr. Lamb, opens the gate in the meanwhile and is breathing rapidly, declares to Mr. Lamb that he has come back, he is back. He looked at him and found him lying on the ground. He went near him and took a closer look and tried to talk to him, but there was no reply. Derry kept on calling him by his name and suddenly started crying. He did so because he realized that Mr. Lamb was dead. Mr. Lamb was no more. A tragic end of this play, students, leaves us with a very heavy heart. We feel sad for Derry because he had finally found a friend who was trying to inject positive thoughts. But towards the end also, we see a ray of hope that this little association with Mr. Lamb will be a turning point in Derry's life. There is a moral behind the story. What is the moral? The positive moral of the story is the ones who are physically challenged and differently abled must focus on the brighter side of the life and they must not brood over the shortcomings they have. All we need to do is to accept physically challenged people as they are. Instead of pitying them, just be good to them. Just be normal. Students, here is a list of glossary which you can go through. When you're reading your textbook, you will need these glossaries. The meanings are mentioned here. Let me do a quick sum up for you to understand what the entire story was about. This play depicts beautifully yet grimly the sad world of physically impaired. It is not the actual pain or inconvenience caused by physical impairment that trouble a disabled man, but the attitude of the people around him. Two physically impaired people, Mr. Lamb with a thin leg and Derry with a burnt face, strike a band of friendship. Derry is described as a young boy, shy, timid, withdrawn, and defiant. People tell him inspiring stories to console him. No one will ever kiss him except his mother, that too on the other side of his face. He mentions about a woman telling that only a mother can love such a face. Mr. Lamb, he revives the almost dead feelings of Derry towards life. He motivates him to think positively about life, changes his mindset about people and things. How a man locked himself as he was scared of, and a picture fell off the wall and got him killed. Everything appears to be the same, but is different. The gate of the garden is always open, which also tells us that Mr. Lamb looks forward for people to come and meet him. Derry is inspired and promises to come back because he started liking Mr. Lamb and his positive attitude towards life. Derry's mother stops him, but he is adamant, saying if he does not go now, it would be never. When he goes back to the garden, he sees Mr. Lamb lying on the ground. It is ironical that when he searches a new foothold to live happily, he finds Mr. Lamb dead. In this way, the play depicts the heart-rendering life of physically disabled people with their loneliness, aloofness, and alienation. But at the same time, it is almost a true account of the people who don't let a person live happily. Students, now we will discuss some questions and answers which you will have to answer for the board exams. Supplementary reader has questions which are mostly opinion-based questions. They carry 4 marks each. It is very important to understand, comprehend the question before answering the question. Usually students make a mistake, they don't understand the question and they write an answer. When that happens, it is obvious that you will not score any marks. So who was Derry? What problems did he have? So Derry is a complex-ridden 14-year-old boy. He is a victim of inferiority complex after acid accidentally spilled and burnt one side of his face. His handicap has filled him with bitterness, and so Derry suffers more on account of the pain that his own views of how everyone hates him causes him. Mr. Lamb has a garden that is full of fruits, flowers, and trees and herbs of all sorts. He likes his garden because it attracts young children, and he gets a sense of pleasure in pulling down the ripe crab apples from the trees and making jelly for the children who visit his garden. The second question, which is often seen in the board exams, is the actual pain or inconvenience caused by physical impairment is often much less than the sense of alienation felt by the person with disabilities. What is the kind of behavior that the person expects from others? This entire chapter, this entire play concentrates on this particular theme, that it is not just the person suffering from his physical problems. It is also the mental agony which is related with his people around him, how they treat him. So the sense of alienation caused by physical impairment is no doubt more painful than the inconvenience caused by physical impairment. This is clearly proved in the play on the face of it. Derry seems to be a living example of this fact. He got his face burnt due to spilling of acid, leaving scars and infirmity. The attitude of the people towards him gave him more pain than his physical pain. He was deeply hurt and disgusted when he realized that his family was anxious about his future. He felt pain when he overheard 2 women talking about his ugly face. The insensitive remarks of people or these women, in which they suggest him to be in the company of people like him, they want him to be with the people of his kind, developed a sense of alienation in him. He closed himself in a shell and developed a very negative attitude to society and finally to life. So what did Derry's mother think of Mr. Lamb? Why? We see that in the story, Derry's mother is not wanting Derry to go back and meet Mr. Lamb. There must be some image she has formed about him. So Derry's mother did not think very highly of Mr. Lamb and claimed to have heard not really good things about him. She had been told and warned by people about Mr. Lamb, and so she tells Derry not to go back to him. She also tried to hold him back, but he does go back to Mr. Lamb. Next question we'll face is, what qualities of Mr. Lamb attracted Derry to him? If you remember in the beginning, when Derry jumped the wall of the garden and walked in, and he realizes that Mr. Lamb was in the garden, he wanted to leave, but he didn't. Mr. Lamb holds him back, and in the end we see him coming back to meet Mr. Lamb. So what are the qualities of Mr. Lamb that brings Derry back to him? What are these qualities? Derry suffers from a terrible complex, but his meeting with Mr. Lamb is a turning point in his life. He gives confidence to Derry and encourages him to develop a positive attitude towards life. Derry's life now has a new meaning and purpose, and for this all, the credit goes to Mr. Lamb's motivation and words of encouragement. Another question which is often seen is, how did Mr. Lamb's meeting with Derry becomes a turning point in Derry's life? Derry's brief association with Mr. Lamb changed him from a bitter, pessimistic, withdrawn and complex-ridden boy to a mature and confident person. His attitude towards life underwent a transformation. Transformation means change. He got encouraged by Mr. Lamb's unending enthusiasm and unceasing zeal. Zeal is excitement to live life. Thus, Mr. Lamb's unfailing optimism helped transform Derry or Derek completely. Mr. Lamb's conversation with him about everything and everybody being essentially the same, his notion, his ideas of beauty being relative, his talk about pretty girls and love, his concept of the world and friendship, and the incident of the timid man all fascinated and inspired Derry. Gradually, Derry was able to shed his old self and rediscover life. He was able to experience the joy of little things of life, like raindrops falling pitter-patter on the roof. He even told his mother, "You shouldn't believe all that you hear." Thus, Derry's brief association with Mr. Lamb became a turning point in his life. This is another question which is often faced in the board exam. Despite all that, the old man, that is Mr. Lamb, says, he is yet a lonely old man. How is this brought out in the course of the play? How does Mr. Lamb overcome this? While reading the play, you will realize that we are talking about Mr. Lamb, who says that he has a lot of friends, but he never can prove that he has friends. He's always alone. He's trying to tell people that he's happy, but in the end, we realize that he's always lonely. So how that is mentioned in the story, and how does he overcome it? Mr. Lamb is an old man with a tin leg. He's alone and lives in a big house with a big lawn. Though he is very optimistic and accepts everything very positively, his loneliness is evident from the fact that he leaves his gate and windows open so that people can come in, and whenever they want, he overcomes this loneliness by getting himself involved in making toffees, jellies, etc., with the crab apples that grow in his garden. He loves to talk and spend time with the children who come to his lawn, although they tease him, "Lamey Lamb." by calling him Lamy Lamb. What is the bond that united the two, the old man, Mr. Lamb, and Derry, the small boy? If you look at it, there is a huge age difference between the two of them. But how did they strike friendship? That is the question. So Derry is a small boy who has a burnt face due to spilling of acid. He is very withdrawn and defiant. He runs away from the world as he hates others staring at him. He thinks people are afraid of his deformity. Similarly, Mr. Lamb too is a handicapped person. He lost one leg in a bomb explosion during the war years ago. He lives alone. The two of them have deformity and are rejected by the people. Both have vacuum in their hearts for not having company. Vacuum is emptiness. Mr. Lamb is a man full of positive energy. When Derry meets him, he finds himself drawn to him. Mr. Lamb seems to be the only one who gives him a new line of thought about his physical disfigurement. What benefits did Derry reap from his association with Mr. Lamb? Derry is a 14 years old boy whose face is partially burnt due to spilling of acid. As a result, he becomes conscious of his ugly face. Derry was encouraged by Mr. Lamb to look at the world, to take interest in the things around him. He found truth, sense, and inspiration in Mr. Lamb's words. In fact, it was Mr. Lamb who brought Derry back to life. Derry learned the way to live life fully by dealing with his deformity in an appropriate manner. The next question is a question which is totally an opinion-based question, and it is up to you students to answer it the way you want. The question is, if you were to give a different ending to the story, on the face of it, how would you end it? I would rather want the story on the face of it to end with a happy reunion between Mr. Lamb and Derry, wherein the two become good friends with one another. Mr. Lamb should continue to influence positivity in and put Derry in a position where he is able to befriend others despite his handicap. This is one answer which you can write, but you have the choice of writing your own answer. Why did Mr. Lamb help Derry? He could have let him go away, but what was it that made Mr. Lamb help Derry? Mr. Lamb and Derry are united by the bond of loneliness and alienation. They share on account of their physical disabilities. Mr. Lamb lost a leg in the war and has a thin leg, while Derry has an acid burn on one side of his face. Mr. Lamb inspires Derry by telling him not to focus on the shortcomings of life and his handicap, and instead he should try to enjoy the blessings of life. He persuades him to develop a positive attitude to move on forward in life. With that, I come to the end of the chapter, students. I would like to thank English Animation for the animation courtesy. Thank you, students. Have a nice day and be safe.
Prudent Scholars, powered by Lupin Pharmaceuticals.
अब आपकी सुरक्षा आपके हाथों में. ल्यूपी सेफ हैंड सैनिटाइजर आपका और चेन्नई सुपर किंग्स का फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस. अब आपकी सुरक्षा आपके हाथों में. ल्यूपी सेफ हैंड सैनिटाइजर आपका और चेन्नई सुपर किंग्स का फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस. अब आपकी सुरक्षा आपके हाथों में. ल्यूपी सेफ हैंड सैनिटाइजर आपका और चेन्नई सुपर किंग्स का फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस.